Hey, everybody, come on in. Come on in. I'm going to get started in just a moment. I have my reference here. That's our breast cancer awareness, Lady Heels with the butterfly. So give me a second. We're going to get started, okay? Make sure you guys have your paint supplies, your paint brushes, your napkins, your apron, if you need your apron. I'm gonna get my apron. All supplies are going to be coming from the 99 cent store, okay? I'll put some good music on. So, got my paint brushes. Okay. Got my water. I've been painting earlier as well too. Okay. Gonna get my colors. So we're basically using a lot of shades of pink. So I personally mix myself some pink using the 99 cent store acrylology paints. So these are the acrylology paints from the 99 cent store. Okay. So I'm gonna start off. So we're gonna be using pink for our heels, our ribbon, and if you want to incorporate pink or any other color in your butterfly, you can as well. Okay. And then of course, your skin tone is gonna be some sort of mine is gonna be brown. You can pull it all the way up if you want to. You can do your background if you want to as well, okay? All right. So we're gonna get started. So throughout the whole process, let me get it over here a little bit. Okay, sorry. All right. Okay. So you're only gonna need the three brushes. I'm gonna get my little container here so I can mix my different paints. These come from 99 cent store as well. Or if you have a Dollar General in your vicinity, Dollar General is great too. So I have my black, touch of my black. And then, of course, I have my pink that I mixed. And then I have another paint that I did not get from a 99 cent store, but I got it from Michaels. And it's a color called magenta. Okay. I'm gonna be using that. But once again, all your colors should come from the 99 cent store, okay? Then I have my skin tone will be this, gonna be a red oxide from the 99 cent store, okay? Right? And then I'm going to use my eggnog from the 99 cent store. This is called eggnog. It's like an off-white color. So between these four colors is what I'm going to use to mix, to lighten, to darken my pinks. Okay. So let me put this one other color on here. Okay. Make sure you guys got your snacks, your beverages. Okay. Don't be like me. Forget your snacks and beverages. I do apologize for not having my paint party last week. I was under the weather. But I hope you guys understand. All right, so we're going to get right into it. So I'm going to grab my small brush. Okay, this is my small brush. So I'm going to mix a little bit of my brown with my eggnog. To give it a lighter brown color. And I'm going to show you guys right now. So this is my brown with my eggnog, and it makes this little color right there. So that's what I'm going to use for my skin tone. Okay. So I'm going to start off by doing her legs first. So I'm going to do it at an angle here. It's so hard to do it at an angle, but I'm going to try and go through the process. And it looks ugly and choppy the first layer, but as you incorporate layer upon layer, it looks less choppy and more like the image you want it to look like. I told you guys I was gonna play a little sexy music. And I hope that you guys like it in the background. So I'm using that small brush or your medium brush. And I'm doing the legs. Okay, that's one leg, right? And then I'm doing the other leg. And for me, I might just do the top of a dress, because I don't think I like the legs just looking all plain. Okay. So what we're incorporating is we're incorporating our skin tone colors. We're incorporating black. We're incorporating our pinks for this paint session. Okay. All right. Get right on in there. Right, that's my skin tone right there. Okay. Right. Okay. So that's that. I'll let that dry. Switch off my colors because I'm gonna do my shoes, her heels. And the heels, we want to get like a lighter color here on the top of the heels. And then at the back, which is the bottom of her heel, we want to give it a darker look to make the colors kind of transition from dark to light, because usually the back of your heel is a little bit darker than your top of your heel. So we want to give it that transition to make it look like it's the top and the bottom, right? So we want to give that the illusion that this is the back of the heel. She's facing her shoe so you can see the back of her heel. So it has a transition of different colors, okay? If you want to make it a red bottom, you can. If you don't, fine as well. If you want to make her her heel, I think this is called a heel, and her tap, different colors you can as well too. Okay, so I'm gonna clean out my brush. You wanna clean that out every time we use different colors. Okay. So I'm going to go right into my pink with my magenta. And I'm going to add a little bit of my eggnog and see what color that gives me. Oh, I like this color. So I've mixed eggnog with my magenta. Or if you had eggnog at the 99 cent store or white, you can mix it with, or with your red or another pink that they have. Okay. And it came out really, really nice. I like it. So I'm going to show you that color. And this is the color right here. Really nice. We're 10 minutes in and we're doing a really good job. I think we're going to leave about here really early, which is good for me because it's Friday. Okay. I'm going to start off with that first, the top of her heel. It's giving like a pastel peachy type of pink. And I think that's good for today. Okay. So that's the top. I'm gonna come over and do the other one. All right. So we had two different images you could have chose to do. I've chose to do this one today. You want to check on our Instagram and Facebook to check the other image if you would like to do that other image in your own leisure. Okay. And like I said, the first layer always looks really, really choppy and ugly. Okay. So that's how it looks for the first layer. I think it looks pretty good. Okay. All right. Let it dry, let it dry, let it dry. We're going to fan it dry. And if you have an actual fan like I do, because I get hot while I'm on my computer, just grab that fan. And guess what? Dollar Tree. Dollar Tree, 99 cent store. I don't spend much for these little items. My canvas, my paint, napkins, easel, anything that you can do that you want to be budget friendly and you're doing it at home. I usually give my customers really, really good canvases. When I'm doing my paint parties. So I don't usually do 99 cent store canvases, even though they're really, really good. I just feel like my customers are special and they deserve a better quality. But the 99 cent store, don't get me wrong, they got some good canvases, y'all. They really do. They really sturdy. They wrap around the back. Got your staples in there. They're real wrap canvases, really sturdy. Like I said, really, really good. But for me, my customers, they're a little bougie, okay? So Pursuit of Peace Painting, we're a little bougie. We're going to give y'all a little better quality. We're going to Michael's, Joann Fabrics. That's what we're going to get y'all stuff at, okay? All right, so I'm letting that dry. And then, ladies and gents, if you think that your painting is not dry, just go ahead and look. Or you can feel that that paint rubs off your finger, which mine did, it's not dry, okay? That way you can't put your next layer on, okay? But since we're waiting for my legs and my shoes to dry, I'm going to just go ahead and dip on in the bottom of that heel and make it darker, like I said, for those transitional looks. Okay, I'm gonna use that straight up magenta and I'm gonna get her bottom of her heel. I'm gonna make that magenta color. Okay. magenta is like a burgundy pink. It's more pinkish than burgundy, but I think it's in the burgundy family. Yeah. So see how that looks? It looks so good. And then I'm gonna go ahead and do those butterflies, right? That magenta, right? And then we can add the little dots of black to the butterflies with the details, okay? You got that should have been popping lately. So I thought I felt Usher in the mix. And happy Breast Cancer Awareness Month, whether you're battling the disease itself or whether you have a loved one that's still here with us or is not here with us. I want to show my appreciation for you guys by incorporating this free breast cancer awareness pan party, virtually, of course. Okay, see? Look good. So I think my legs are dry enough for me to add another coat. So I'm gonna switch out my brush into a little bit flatter brush. And we're just gonna call this the medium brush, okay? So switch your medium, if you want to switch it out a medium brush, you go right back into my eggnog mixed with my brown. Mix it up a little bit more. And add one more coat to my legs. So hopefully it makes it look a little bit less choppier and more cleaner, a more clear look, which that is the case. That's what it's doing. And these two paints come from the 99 cent store. Acrylology paint. I may not be saying that right, but sounds right to me. So, all right, see, it already looks good. Okay, I'm gonna clean it up with my black lines and stuff like that, but for right now, it does the job. Okay, Ursh. All right. Okay. Right, that looks much better, right? Okay. So now all right. Okay. So now I just cleaned up a little bit. Can't really see from the side, right? So now, clean on my brush again, get to that little pastel pink that I made using my magenta and my eggnog. And use that one now. And I believe it's dry. I'm looking at it, it's really dry. So I'm gonna add another coat. Okay, another coat over here. right? All right. So adding that second coat looks really, really good. Okay. Get my little, switch it out. Then I'm gonna do the bottom of her shoe with that transition color magenta, right? All right, so that's, we got that. Then I'm gonna do them butterflies. Okay. I think that's a little too gangster for y'all. I'm gonna switch it out with the music. That's a little too gangster. Okay. So this is how it looks. Boop, 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 boop. Now, here's where it gets a little fun for me at least, right? I'm gonna try to mix another color to make another pink. So I'm gonna probably use that pale pink and that magenta, right? To try to make another pink to do the actual breast cancer ribbon, okay? Right? So I made another pink from the magenta that I had and the pale pink. So that's the pink I made right there. Right there, okay. And I'm gonna do the ribbon, okay? I didn't really wanna touch the ribbon yet. Okay. Oh, sorry, guys. I'm sorry. Now I'll switch it out to my small brush. Okay. Right. Then I'm going to make it a little bit fancier. Even though it's wet, I'm going to go ahead and still use, clean my brush off. Dab it on my napkin, get the excess water off, and go ahead into the magenta and kind of make it a little different. Just get streaks of the magenta in there. I'm not going to overdo it. So it gives it a little bit of transition. I'm not sure if you can see it. A little bit of ombre-ish look. Ish. Can't see it. I can see it, but yeah. All right. So next, my final thing on her shoe, I'm going to use that black now and paint her taps and her actual heel. Okay. Because I don't want to black the merge in any colors, so. And black is another color that comes from the 99 cent store. Okay, small brush to get into those little details. And the other peel. Okay. Cute. I think it's cute too, right? So after I'm done with that, cleaned up a little bit, got a little moment of OCD. Okay, after I'm done with that, then I'm gonna make these little dots, random little dots inside the butterfly. They don't have to be real dots, just the dots enough to be like, oh, that's a butterfly. Okay. Yep, it's a butterfly. Right? Then I'm gonna rinse my brush off. And then I'm gonna go in there and dab a couple dabs of that eggnog inside the butterflies. Okay. Randomly or on top of the same black dots. Okay. Dots, it can be little smudges. Okay. See that? Right? I love it. Okay. So now, so I see that my, because sometimes these colors, even though they're really good in heavy body paints, see, they don't really drip down like that. They're really good. They can take more than two layers, but to give you the look that you really, really want. And for me, since I have OCD, I'm going to do one more layer of my brown to give it a complete, cohesive look. I'm going to do another layer of my magenta to give another cohesive look. And then I'm going to put another layer of top of the new pink color I made on my ribbon to make it pop, okay? So I'm going to start off by doing my magenta on the bottom of her shoe. Okay. Now, next, I'm going to switch it out for my small brush. Okay. And get that new pink that I made and go back over my ribbon. Right? Okay. Then I'm gonna use my pink and go back over her shoe. Cause I see a couple of little imperfections that I don't like. And I want it to look perfect. I'm gonna go over here to the other shoe. Uh-oh, see? And that's exactly why I'm gonna use black right now. Cause now the black got smudged in the shoe. But we're gonna make it work out. It's okay, it's okay. It's a mistake, but I think I like it. Okay. Right? So now, I'm gonna let that dry. And now it's time for y'all to snack. If you want a snack, or if you want to go ahead and get your beverage, that's time to do that now. Okay, then I'm gonna go small brush. I'm gonna go over my lines again. Oh. Go with my butterfly again. The outlines. This sideways version is kind of messing me up, but I like it. And I'm gonna go ahead and make my little butterfly eyes again. I'm gonna come over here and do the same thing to this one. Do my outline. Eyes, good. Now I'm gonna do my outline of actually not the bottom of her shoe. I'm not going to go on the inside yet until I actually finish her another layer of brown. I'm just making all the lines look crisp and nice. Okay. Crisp and nice. Okay. So now I'm going to go ahead and one more layer of my brown. I think I'm going to leave my background white. I think that works for me. You don't have to do that. Okay. You do not have to do that at all. I'm going to mix it out. Get back in my brown. But my, what is it called? Red oxide messing with my eggnog. All right. All right. Okay. So I'm going to go over her legs one more time. One more time, she's about to be fine. Now, I'm risking it all because I have not allowed none of my black to dry. I just don't want y'all to be on here that long. So I'm not rushing, but I'm rushing. Okay. I honestly thought this was going to take a little bit longer than it did, but it did not, right? Okay, so for the last part, I'm going to make a skirt, the top of skirt. Make a skirt, and I hope it works. Okay, all right. So I'm gonna just kind of make a line, a wiggly line on top of her leg, wiggle it on out. Then I'm gonna go up here, wiggle it on out, try to see how it's gonna work out. Then I'm gonna wiggle back here. Right, I'm just freestyling, right? So in between there, I'm gonna paint. And I think it worked on out, y'all. It worked out. I'm gonna do the top. To make it a little cohesive look. Nothing, that's cute. But freestyle, y'all, that's cute. Guess what? I ain't even stopping there, right? So I got the top of the legs covered enough to where it looks like a dress, that it looked like it's supposed to be there. Okay. Because I just couldn't let that go. I just couldn't, right? So now I'm about to, without, I just cleaned my brush off a little bit, but I'm gonna go in my little light pink that I made, right? It's starting to get a little stiff. Does that make enough? I need to make a little bit more. So I'm adding my eggnog with my magenta to make this color. A little bit more eggnog. Right? To make that pale, pale pink. And then I'm gonna go back up in here while it's wet and kind of streak it on out. To make an ombre look. But like she has a pink poof dress on, right? Remember those pink silk poof dresses that we used to wear back in the day? Not too back in the day, because I ain't that old, right? So I like it. I really like it. If you want to be fancier, right, why not add some roses, right? So how you add roses, take my small brush, add a dot, and just kind of swirl it around. Dot and swirl it around. Dot and swirl it around. Ain't got to be nothing fancy. We can alternate with the eggshell, eggnog. Dot, swirl around. 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 Right? Don't that look cute? I thought so too. Yeah. Right? So now at the very end, I usually do all my paint parties. I usually get the smallest brush I have in my arsenal, right? And I outline everybody's work in black to make it look, make it pop, right? So why not do the same thing for my art, right? So I get my small paintbrush that has a little point at the end, and I just kind of work it around each detail. Of course, that's my family in the background. Yeah. All right. Okay. All right. See, make it look pop. Make it pop. Make it pop, pop, pop. Right? And of course, I'm going to do the outlining of my breast cancer awareness ribbon. Okay, sorry about that. All I'm doing is just going all around all my lines, making them crisp and nice and neat. Okay? And that is it, right? So now at the very end, the very, very end, right? Let me go ahead and fix my heel. Hello. Yeah. An earthquake. Okay. Uh-oh. Now I messed up. That's fine. I'm just making my heel a little bit bigger. Now my heel is a platform. Ish. Okay. It still looks good, but yeah. All right. Okay. So there we go. All right. So at the very end, I do my outlines, and then I write something fancy. Today, we're going to do hope. I know it looks backwards. I know it looks crazy. But I promise it says hope. Okay. Right, guys? So this is our breast cancer awareness paint and sip. We thank you for joining us. We hope to see you again next month for some latest images and free virtual paint party. And if you'd like to book a paint party if you're local in the Bay Area of California, go ahead and hit the link in my bio, which is pursuitofpeacepainting.com. You can go to our Instagram, Pursuit of Peace Painting in Instagram. You can go to our Facebook, that's Pursuit of Peace Painting. And yeah, hit us up. We are glad to accommodate you in however that looks. We are also a one-stop shop, meaning that we also have tables, chairs, canopies, tents, projector screens. We do kid parties. We do adult parties, anything in between. And we are super, super focused. Super, super focused. I know that's over the top, but super, super focused on bridging the gap between creativity and mental health. Okay. So we call our sessions our therapy sessions. Now, I am not a certified therapist, right? I'm not a therapist, right? But these art parties or virtual art parties are very, very imperative to have for people's mental health. So I call my paint parties our therapy sessions, right? And they're very, very holistic. And I love them. My customers love them. So we hope that we see you soon. Next month, we'll give you some dates. Maybe next week, we'll give you the dates for November. We're going to have 2 virtual paint parties. Of course, they're going to be free. Of course, the same time is going to be from 6 to 7:30. And we hope to see you there. All right, guys. Have a good night. And like I said, hit us up at Pursuit of Peace Painting virtually through our website, through Instagram or Facebook. Okay. Thank you. Have a good one.